Hi guys, hello everyone. We just wait for the audience to build up, then we kick off today's chat. You're all welcome to Toyinbi's World. Hope you're all fine. Hope you've been having a very good week. Hope your weekend was great. Hope all is well with you and yours, my beautiful viewers. It's nice to be back again on this lovely Tuesday. Nice to have you guys with me on board for another lovely chat. So like I said earlier, we're just going to like wait for the audience to build up. We'll give it like 5 minutes. Once we have a considerable number of people watching, we kick off the show, right? Well, I hope you're all good. Hope everyone is good, 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 good. We kick off in 5 minutes, guys, so please just chill. Chill, chill, chill. Invite your friends, share the video. Let's have a quick chat. It's another Tuesday, it's Toyinbi's World Show. It's another Tuesday. If you're on board, say hi. And where you're saying hi from, let me know. What part of the world are you saying hi from? Kindly invite your friends to join us and share the video so that we can have fun. So who's here? Who's watching? Hi, Derele. Only Derele I have on board that I'm seeing. Anyway, hi, everyone watching. Today's chat is going to be a bit brief and, of course, interesting and educative. So, Lala, I appreciate you if you invite your friends and share the video as well. So, I kick off in 3 minutes. Maybe I said 5 minutes, like 5 minutes ago at me. Okay, so in 3 minutes, time we'll start, all right? Okay, I'm seeing quite a number of people on board. Hi, everyone watching. Just give me like 3 minutes and we'll start. Okay, we'll start off, right? One time, I think I'm okay with the number of people I have. Okay, hi guys. Hello, everybody. Good evening and welcome to another episode of Toyinbee's World. My name is Oluwatoyin Noimat Balogun. Today's chat is going to be a bit brief. You know, I won't talk for long. Because I have a sore throat, so I need to rest my throat. My throat really hurts. My voice is croaky, and you know, I can't really talk well. I can't even swallow. So I'm gonna take the lime, lemon, and honey that I have here in very hot water just to help my situation. Sorry, excuse me. So I'm gonna be doing a lot of that. You guys have to pardon me. Anyway. Let's say hi to some people before we start. Who's watching? Hi, hi, hi. If you're watching, say hello. Say hi to me. Let me know you're watching me live in wherever you are. Okay, so we start. Yeah. So tonight, it's already 6:32 here. Airing this video from Dubai. So, okay, Vera Alumuko says hi. Hi, Vera. Where are you saying hi from? What part of the world are you saying hi from, Vera? Are you in Nigeria? Is this thing frozen or what? Whatever. Okay. Vera, where are you watching from? Okay, anyway, so I am going to be talking about I'm going to be talking about something tragic that happened in Nigeria on Sunday. So, from what happened, I'm going to use that to derive the message I'm passing on today, right? I'm going to use the situation, what actually happened, the incident. I'm going to use it to pass on a message to everybody watching this video now and everybody who's going to watch it later, you know, and I'll appreciate it if you share the video because it's a powerful message, and I know that a lot of people will benefit from what I'm going to say. I am very, very sure about that. So on Sunday evening, in Lagos, Nigeria, some guy who allegedly was a doctor was he was reported to have committed suicide. We understand the guy finished church service. He was being driven in his SUV, and what we heard was he asked his driver to pull over, like he wanted to like ease himself. That's what the driver thought, and that's what we're hearing. Nobody knows the truth, you know. We understand this doctor named Oji Orwell. People thought he wanted to. His driver thought he wanted him to pull over so that he could urinate, you know, not knowing that he wanted to jump into the lagoon. So apparently, that was what Dr. Orwell Oji did on Sunday evening after church service, some Lagos Island, that third mainland bridge in Lagos, right? So. My point now is nobody knows what the doctor was going through. Nobody knows what he was feeling. Nobody knows what prompted him to jump into the lagoon. Nobody knows what he was going through mentally, you know, only God knows. But what I'm about to say may sound a bit harsh, but I know I'm right, you know, because I believe in myself. Not that I'm full of myself, but I believe in myself to an extent, you know. The act of suicide is Selfish. That's my belief. I think it's selfish, is ungodly, is pathetic. You know, why would anybody want to kill himself or herself? I know everybody has issues. Everybody has issues. It's just the way we handle these issues that really matters. How is the doctor even sure that what is going on in my own head? What is in my heart and in my mind? Everything that I have in my mind is not even much more than what he was thinking or what he had in his mind or heart. You know, it's just the way people react to situations that makes them, the way that people react to situations and incidents that makes them really different and unique. You know, everybody has issues, not just in Nigeria, everywhere. It might be minor issue, it might be a major issue. Everybody has issues. That's just the truth. As you're looking at me now, I have a lot of things on my mind. I swear to God, a lot of things going on in my head. And I would not want to kill myself for whatever reason. Why? Then at the end of the day, it's not even godly. God will be very upset with whoever commits suicide. You did not make your own life. You cannot even make anything. You cannot give anything breath. So why on earth would you take your own life? You know, just because, you know. It does not make sense at all. So the guy, may his soul rest in peace, Dr. Oji, he might have had mental issues, spiritual issues, physical issues, medical issues, financial issues, emotional issues, relationship issues, whatever issue he may have had, you know. Every issue, every problem, every challenge has an expiry date. Whatever it is would have come to an end someday, sometime, somehow, whatever it is. I know it's not easy. I'm just saying this, you know, but I know, I believe in what I'm saying myself, honestly, because life is a phase. Things happen, things change, people change. Nothing, no condition is permanent. No condition is ever permanent. Whatever situation you find yourself in today, no matter how bad it is, it will not last forever. Definitely, it will definitely not last forever. So just look forward to a bright future. Look forward to a bright tomorrow, you know. So my word, my message today, why I'm coming out today is people all over, everybody watching me and everybody who watch this video later, please try and be nice to everybody you meet. Even people you don't know, try and be nice to everybody, even on social media, even on blogs, even while leaving your comments, even in real life, even to strangers. It might just be a smile. It might just be a kind gesture, you know, like helping someone open the door or, you know, bringing out the chair for a person to sit, you know, or helping an elderly person cross the street. You know, be kind in your thoughts and deeds to mankind. Nobody knows what people are going through. We're all just wearing clothes, wearing makeup, looking pretty, you know. You never know what is going on deep down in people's lives and people's hearts and people's minds and people's souls, you know. So my belief is, if you don't have anything good to say or do, don't say or do anything, really. If you don't have anything to contribute positively to anybody's life or work or to anybody's to anybody in life or on social media, don't do anything. Don't say anything. It's not by force you say something or do something. Honestly, you know. So this Dr. Oji now, people would have known him as well. From what I read, I heard he was pretty cool. He was very warm. People liked him. His colleagues at work in Mount Sinai, where he was working, liked him. You know, of course, he would have had a few haters. Only God knows. And you know, my point is, men looking at him in his medical outfit, the white robe thing, and people be like, "Oh my God, what a cute guy! 35-year-old guy, what a cute guy!" You know. People would not have known what he was going through in his heart, in his mind, and in his life, you know. So imagine that kind of person now coming online, sharing a picture, maybe on his Facebook page, or no, let me just say on Instagram, You know, that doctor, for example, you know how social media is. People from all walks of life, the good, the bad, and the ugly, just spring up and leave messages. You know, sometimes, most times, the messages are not cool at all. So imagine that kind of doctor now, after having put his picture up on Instagram and people bombarding him with negative comments. Imagine how he would have felt. You know, it might be a tiny thing. That might be maybe not a big deal, but little things go a long way. Honestly, little things go a long way. By the time people write, oh, you're so ugly. See how you look. You're so skinny. See your legs. See your hair. See your head, you know. In spite of what he's going through emotionally or financially or spiritually, you can even imagine. So if you don't have anything good to say, if you don't have anything positive or constructive to say, to add up to one's life, to edify one in life, just do it. Just take a walk. So you don't need to say anything. You don't need to do anything. If it's not positive or adding impact or adding value to people, even on social media. Right now, the videos I watch, even on social media, they must add value to my life. I just don't watch any video on Facebook this anymore. From like beginning of this year, all those negative and silly videos that don't add value to my life, I cut them off. I've actually cut them off. People that would not add any value to my life too. Not that I even hung out with them or they hung out with me before. But now it's even worse. I even like fashioned all of them now. You don't even see me with them or you don't see them with me anymore. And people too, if they feel I can't add value in any way to them, even on social media and in real life, they should feel free to delete me. That's just it. If anything or anyone does not edify you, there's no point. You know, if you're in a room and you're the most brilliant person in the room and you're the most intelligent and the brightest and the most brilliant and the most, you know, and the coolest person in the room, you're in the wrong room. That is it. You're in the very wrong room. You need to be in a room where the people there are much more educated and more intelligent than you. They will be able to give you things. They have things to offer you. So you yourself, you'll be adding value. They'll be adding value to you. So don't feel cool when everybody licks your ass and like, oh yeah, the yes, yes people. No, you're hanging out with the wrong set of people. Hang out with people that will add value to your life. Be positive, be nice, let your thoughts and gesture to man be kind. That is my message for today. And honestly, it's very, very important. Not just in real life, on social media. Let your thoughts and your gesture to man be kind, right? And when I say be kind, I do not mean like, even like, okay, somebody comes to complain to me now like, oh, Toy, I have a business thing and I need, it's going to cost me like $10,000. I have $8,000. I need $2,000 more. You know, can you please help me with the balance of $2,000? You know, assuming I don't even have the $2,000 to lend the person, right? I will not like sell the person off or discourage him from the business or, you know, even if I don't have the money to lend him, I would advise him on how to go about it. I would be there for him. I would, you know, listen to him. I'll listen to what he has to say. We'll talk about it together. We'll talk about the way forward, where he can go, you know. So it's not all about money, 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 money. When I say help, when you let your thoughts and gestures be nice, be kind to mankind, I don't mean only financial, honestly. It might just be a smile. It might just be an advice. It might just be a lending air you give to someone. It might just be your time. It might just be anything, you know. But the message for today is let your thoughts and your action, your deeds, be kind unto men. Right? Alumuku. Hi, Alumuku. You've not told me where you're saying hi from. I hope you're cool anyway. This is the first time I'm seeing you here. Anyway, you're welcome to Toyin B's World. So, before we go on to the next, still the same topic, right? My message is let your thoughts and your action to your gesture to man be kind. Before we go on to the second phase of that chat, would like to take a few comments. Let me just read a few comments and acknowledge some people. Okay, Vera Alumoko says she's saying hi from the UK. All right, good to have you. Hi, Vera from UK. Hi, Vera from UK. Right, anyway, so now the poor doctor now, after having spent at least 7 years in medical school, what am I saying? 7 years in the university. No, no. In my own time, anyway, UNILAG, you'd spend a year in the University of Lagos, then you'd do like 5 years in Medilag, then 1 or 2 years internship or whatever they did then. So altogether, it was 7 years then. I don't know how many years now it is. I'm talking about like 15 years ago, you know. So after having spent like 15 years, after having spent like 7 years in the university, that's how Dr. Orwell Oji ended his own life. That's how he just went like that. God will rest your soul and comfort your family by the grace of God, Dr. Oji. Anyway, so another thing I'm going to say is, another thing I'd like to say is, sorry, I'm short-sighted, so I have to move close to read comments on that phone. All right. So anyway, I'm seeing quite a number of people watching. I'd like to thank you guys for coming on board. Kindly feel free to leave your comments, share the video, and invite your friends. And take note that most times, most Tuesdays in the evening, I'm always live talking about global news or events or whatever I have to say, be it inspirational, motivational, whatever message I have to pass on. I try to reach as many people as I can on my platform and on my blog to pass on my message, right? So I welcome everybody to Tony B's World. I really, really appreciate you coming on board. And yeah, welcome to this 14th episode of TBW. Like I said, my name is Oluwatoyin Oimatsubalogun, and I'm airing this video live from Dubai at the moment. I'm in Dubai at the moment. I shuttle between Dubai and Abu Dhabi. So you're all welcome to my world. Okay, so another issue now, after this Dr. Orwell Oji committed suicide on Sunday evening in Lagos, Nigeria. Today's Tuesday, a couple of days ago, right? I don't know where or how this started. Some blogger or some journalist must have gone to Facebook and searched for an Orwell Oji. So there's another Oji Orwell, right? But let me just put it this way. The Oji Orwell, the doctor who allegedly committed suicide, his name is Orwell Oji. That's A-L-L-W-E-L-L, then Oji, O-R-J-I, right? So apparently, a journalist or a blogger, the day he died on that Sunday when he committed suicide, must have searched on Facebook for an Orwell Oji. Maybe there was no Orwell Oji the way I spelled it on Facebook, but there is an Orwell Oji on Facebook. This Orwell Oji is not A-L-L-W-E-L-L-O-R-J-I. It is Oji Orwell. That's O-J-I, then Orwell, O-L-L-A-L-L-W-E-L. W-E-L-L, right? The one that died, the doctor who committed suicide, is Orwell Oji. A-L-L-W-E-L-L, then Oji, O-R-J-I, right? Then the one that is on Facebook that is still alive, who is a nurse in Port Harcourt, is Oji Orwell. His own Oji does not have an R. It's O-J-I, then Orwell, A-L-L-W-E-L-L, right? So this Oji is very much alive. That's the nurse. This one is a nurse, not the doctor who committed suicide. And it's not based in Lagos, it's based in Port Harcourt. So there must have been a mistake somewhere. A blogger or a journalist went to Facebook and got his pictures. That's a living Oji. And put it as the Oji Orwell that died. So FYI, for your information, guys, Oji Orwell, who is a nurse in Port Harcourt, is very much alive, right? We apologize. I may have actually put the wrong picture as well in one of my blog posts, you know. So I apologize to the living Oji Orwell, whose pictures everybody is using in Nigeria, like he's the one who committed suicide. So I hope this may not sound insensitive, right? I would, well, implore or would like if the late Oji's family, the doctor who actually committed suicide, if they can release picture of the late Oji himself, the doctor, you know, so that there will not be any conflict, there will not be any confusion anymore, you know, so that the real Oji will know that, yes, he's alive, it was just a mistake, they're using his pictures, and now they're not using his pictures again. So if the late doctor, the family of the late doctor, could provide pictures of the doctor, the late, their son or their husband or their brother who committed suicide on Sunday, would really appreciate that, so that we'll stop confusing using Oji Orwell's picture as the Dr. Orwell Oji who committed suicide, right? So that's it basically. So please note, take note of the message again. Try to be nice to everybody, people you meet, you know, even people on your way up, because you never know, you just might meet them on your way down. Try to be nice to people. Don't be full of yourself. Try to be very nice to people in everything you do, really, in everything you do. In everything you do, be nice. Be very nice. Because even your kind gesture can change someone, it can change your life, it can change the situation, it can help anybody. So be nice to people you meet and people you don't even know. Be nice to strangers. Just because you're not getting anything, somebody doesn't mean you would not be nice to the person. Or just because you don't know the person, does not mean you should not be nice to the person. Be nice to people, strangers, everybody. Right? Okay. Iyapo Balogun said, well said. Thank you for coming on board, Iyabo Balogun. Thank you for sharing and thank you for leaving your comment. So Kema Emina goes noted. Oh, Kema, hi Kema, how are you doing today? Right, so before we go back to that topic again, let me just inform everyone, if you know anybody who is in this particular situation, who you may think is suicidal, or if you yourself are thinking of negative things, if you feel broken, if you feel rejected, dejected, depressed, if you feel lonely, you're sad, you feel nothing is going right, you feel, you know, it's just the end. If you yourself are feeling that way, or you know anybody feeling that way, and you're in Nigeria, there's a number you can call, right? The Nigerian Suicide Prevention Initiative. The hotline is +234 806 210 6493. I'll take that again. If you're feeling sad, depressed, or you know anybody who you think may be suicidal, somebody who's feeling broken, if it's not you or you know someone who is actually feeling that way, the Nigerian Suicide Prevention Initiative, the hotline is +234 806 210 6493. Please take note and share the number, you know, to on your social media pages. Share the video so that, you know, somebody may benefit from this message. You never know. You just never know. You may be saving a life or two. So share the number, share the video, let people know what I'm talking about. Right, so, okay, so we'll take a short break and, okay, Esuku Freshe Tinminepre, sorry if I didn't pronounce that properly, right, he says, watching from Accra, Ghana, keep the orientation up, thank you. Esuku, and I'm sorry if I didn't pronounce your name properly. I'm so sorry, but you're welcome on board, and thank you for the lovely compliment. Thank you for the compliment. Thank you for the lovely comments. Yeah. So, I'm going to go on a short break now before we go to the final phase of this chat. So please feel free to leave your comments, invite your friends, and to share the video. I hope my voice doesn't sound so bad because I told you I have a sore throat. I hope it's not that bad. It's passive? Voice, guys, nice or hard? Is it guys, so you help me. Olu Jimmy Ibukun goes, may you rest in peace. Amen. Ibukun, how is my voice? Because I have a sore throat. How does it sound on the phone or laptop or your hearing that you're using to watch me? I hope it's not horrible. Okay, so we'll take a break. Please leave your comments before we go to the final phase of the chat. Today, I told you it's going to be a brief one, you know, so I just came out to pass on this very important message. And I'm glad to have a few people on board. Very, very happy. So. All right, so like I said before, like I said earlier, my name is Toyin Balogun. I am a blogger in Dubai and Abu Dhabi. I live in Abu Dhabi. I shuttle between Abu Dhabi and Dubai. Let me just say, I live in the UAE. And I run a blog called Toyin B's World. And the blog is all about general global news, trending news, breaking news. And we talk about trending things. Fashion, lifestyle, event. Well, my forte is events and entertainment. Most times I go for events, I cover the events. I go back to my blog, write the review of the events, and sometimes I give exclusive, most times, not sometimes, I give interviews backstage or when I meet all the celebrities from Nigeria, Africa, or America, wherever they come from. We give them, you know, impromptu, sometimes planned interviews, you know. So everything I put on the blog. So most times, yeah, this is my episode. A couple of episodes that I aired on this Facebook live chat. I talked about the news on my blog. So most times I talk about news on the blog as well, Toyin B's World. So I'd like to inform you that there's so many trending news now. On the blog, we need to, once we finish this conversation, this endeavor to. Okay, Olujimi says, cool, it's audible, all well, nice. Thank you, Olujimi. Anyway, so when we finish this chat, we finish this our conversation, do not hesitate to visit the blog Toyin B's World, www.toyinbalogun.com, toyinbalogun.com. And Toyin B's World, www.toyinbalogun.blogspot.com. So trending on the blog are, we have updates on Apostle Johnson and what's her name again? Stephanie Otobo Saga. We have an update on that. We also have an update on this British guy, James Kingston, who was caught and who was arrested in Dubai for climbing cranes. James Kingston is a young British guy. He's quite popular on YouTube and Instagram and later on Facebook. He goes to countries that have skyscrapers. So he climbs cranes and buildings, you know, without any form of protection or whatsoever. So he's climbed a number of towers here in Dubai. You know, check him out on YouTube and Instagram, James Kingston. So recently he climbed one of the towers in Dubai. He put it up on social media. So it went viral and people got note of what he did and they thought it wasn't safe because, you know, they feel still he's passing on the wrong message to people. Like, they wouldn't know that you're a pro before you can do such a thing without any prevention or protection or whatever. You know, you can't just climb a skyscraper and feel, even if you don't know how, you won't fall down and you will not die. And for the long story short, he was arrested. And yeah, he's back in the UK. They report him, really. Just voting that he can climb or cranes and towers in Dubai without any permission. So he's back in the UK and have the details. He actually spoke out. He told us what happened from the beginning to end, you know, the way he was taken for interrogation and all that. He put it up on his YouTube channel. So everything is on the blog. Update on Apostle Johnson and Suleiman, Apostle Johnson Suleiman and Stephanie Otobo saga. Update on James Kingston. Then last Friday was St. Paddy's Day. Paddy's Day, that's St. Patrick's Day. It's an Irish celebration. Dubai and Abu Dhabi were not left out in the celebration. A few of our buildings, monumental buildings, went green in Dubai and Abu Dhabi. So you can check that out on the blog as well. How Dubai and Abu Dhabi went green for St. Patrick's Day on Friday. Our Burj Al Arab was green. The Irish village went green. The Yas Marina went green. A lot of buildings in the UAE went green. So you can see the beautiful pictures up on the blog. So in Biz World later, or now, if you wish. Then we also have the video of the Oni of Ife being interviewed by CNN Africa. It's on the blog. So many things, so many news, not just about Nigeria and Nigerians, global news you'll find on the blog. Very interesting news, educative, entertaining, interactive, you know. It's just the blog you need to follow, the blog you need to subscribe to your Biz World. So guys, can you post his name? Whose name, Jimmy? Whose name are you talking about? Olu Jimmy Buku. I don't know whose name you're talking about. Can you post his name? Whose name? I don't know. Can you let me know whose name you're talking about, Ibuku? I don't understand that. I don't know whose name. So who's here? Who's watching? Who's live with me? Who wants to say hi? Kindly say hi and tell me where you're saying hi from. Oh yeah, and one more thing. If you're a makeup artist and you're based in Dubai, can you please leave your contacts on this chat, please, on this thread. I'll check it out later and revert, right? If you're a makeup artist in Dubai, right, please leave your contact details on this thread. I'll check it out later. I need to get in touch with you ASAP, right? So how are you guys doing? How's your week been? How's your week been? Oh, the guy who climbed the skyscraper, James Kingston. It's on my blog. You see the video and his picture up on my blog, Toying Biz World. James, J-A-M-E-S, then Kingston, K-I-N-G-S-T-O-N, James Kingston, the young British guy. He travels all over the world to climb cranes and towers and buildings, and, you know, he puts them up on Instagram and Facebook and YouTube. Yeah, James. I put it up on Twitter. He retweeted the tweet, apparently. I put it up to, was it? Yesterday. So who else is here? Prince Kennedy says hello, dear. Hi, Prince Kennedy. How are you doing? How you doing? Oops. Hope you're fine, 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 fine. All right, so I'm gonna like round off in 5 minutes, 5, 10 minutes. If you wanna say hi, please say hi. Okay, Prince Kennedy says he's watching from India. Nice, Prince Kennedy. Welcome on board. What part of India are you watching from? What part of India are you watching from? Are you in New Delhi or Calcutta or? Please endeavor to share the video. Let it go. Let it touch somebody. Somebody may just need the message I passed on today. It may be of help to anyone. Please share the video. We're going to be here for another 5 minutes. You can invite your friends to join us. Let them feel free to contribute to today's topic, today's message, which is let your thoughts and your gesture be kind to man. Let your thoughts and your gesture to man be kind. Happy Destiny goes good morning. Good morning, Ke. Good morning, Bibo. You know, it's 7:07 p.m. here and now. It's 7:07 p.m. That's evening. There's no morning here. Why are you saying hi from Happy? Why are you saying good morning from Happy Destiny? Morning, Bibo. When we're already done for today, we're thinking of chilling. Musa Prince goes, you look pretty, girl. I'm not a girl, but thanks for the compliment. I'm a lady. I'm a lady woman. I'm not a girl, but thanks for the beautiful compliment. Thanks for the comment. Okay, Happy Destiny says from Texas. Oh, okay. Texas, Houston, Texas, USA. You're welcome on board, Happy Destiny. Okay, Prince Kennedy in Mumbai. Oh, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Beautiful. So did you get today's gist? Did you hear about the Nigerian guy who committed suicide on Sunday? If you guys missed out on that, if you missed the news, please visit the blog for the information. And you can rewatch this video later or on my YouTube channel if you want to know what we talked about. Oh, you didn't hear? Ah, Prince Kennedy says no. Happy Destiny says no. Oh dear. And I'm a blogger. I'm sad. I don't want to be a carrier of sad news, but as a blogger, I need to tell or inform people what is going on globally. And you know, this Nigerian guy, his name is a doctor. He was a doctor. His name is Dr. Orwell Orji. On Sunday, after leaving church, after church service, he was being driven by his driver. Okay, Happy says he does. Okay. His driver was driving his Jeep, his SUV, and he asked the driver to pull over somewhere in on Third Mainland Bridge. The driver, these are reports though, these are things we heard. I only know of one person that was there. I have a friend who I grew up with in Lagos, Nigeria, and when she was feeling sad and writing how she felt about the guy's suicide, one of her friends who was there when the thing happened, left her comments. So I'm very sure that it happened because I know my friend very well. She doesn't lie. And I trust that person that left the message too. I don't want to drop names, you know. Like she was there when it happened and you left everybody confused, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, but since I wasn't there, I would say reports, right? Hearsay. Right, so we heard that this doctor asked his driver to pull over on the Third Mainland Bridge, thinking he wanted to urinate. The driver pulled over. The guy, after receiving a call in the car, just went to the side of the bridge and jumped into the lagoon. He died. Till today, they're still looking for his body. 35-year-old guy, medical doctor in Mount Sinai Hospital, Dr. Oji Orwell Oji. So right, there's another guy who is a nurse. His name is Oji Orwell. That one is based in Port Harcourt. That one is still very much alive, but unfortunately, you know, bloggers and websites and journalists and newspapers, they're using the guy, the OG, who is still very much alive, they're using his picture as to pass for the one who committed suicide because they have similar names. But Oji, O-J-I, Allwell, A-L-L-W-E-L-L, is still very much alive, but the Dr. Oji Allwell, who committed suicide, is gone. And his own Oji has R-O-R-J-I. Anyway, so that's about it. Happy Destiny says fake news. No, it's not fake news. It really happened. Prince Kennedy says, well, yes, well, sadly. So we're praying for Dr. Orwell Oji's soul to rest in peace and for God to comfort his family and his loved ones. Suicide is not a funny thing. It's not a joke, honestly. And depression is bad as well. Suicide stems from depression. Depression sometimes leads to suicide. Not in all cases, but in most cases, you know. So we just have to be careful, prayerful, be nice. Bottom line is be nice to people because you never know what people are going through deep down. Everybody has one issue or the other. Nobody's perfect. Nobody's issue-free. Trust me. I've been there. I know what is happening. Nobody in this world is issue-free. Nobody. It might just be a minor issue. It might be a mega issue. It might be one issue. It might be multiple issues. But nobody is issue-free. It is the way that we handle these issues that makes us unique, different, and that makes us stand out, you know. So for everyone out there, know that no condition is permanent. And there are people you can talk to if you feel down. But apart from God, there are physical people you can talk to one-on-one. If you don't trust friends, if you don't want to confide in friends with whatever that is bothering you, you can see professionals. You can seek help from with therapists and counselors. You can get advice and solution and help from those people, from the professionals. So don't just fool you alone. People are there to help you. People are out there to assist you any way they can. So that is what we are talking about. Happy Destiny, it is not fake news. It's real news. It really happened, sadly. It really did happen. Right? So. So we'll just chat for another couple of minutes. Then we say ciao, ciao, ciao. So how's your day been, guys? What are you guys up to? Okay, happy says. Okay. All right, say hi. Let's just have a quick chat before I sign off for today. Who's there? I can't see the name properly. Okay, anyway, I see you. Hi. Okay, Shagun says you're beautiful. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Shagun, for the compliment. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. So that's it, all guys. Bottom line, repeat. Be nice to people. Be nice to everyone you meet, people you don't even know. Be it a smile you're giving, be it an advice, be it your time, be it a comment, be it an action, a deed, a gesture, be it whatever. Let your thoughts and your gestures to man be kind. Always remember that. Always, always remember that. Okay, Happy Girls, how about the issue of Nigeria people in Dubai? What do you mean by, how about the issue of Nigeria people in Dubai? What do you mean by that, Happy Destiny? Can you break it down, please? What do you mean by the issue of Nigerian people in Dubai? Happy Destiny, can you tell me what you mean before I go? Because I'm signing out in a couple of minutes. Nigerian people in Dubai. I don't know. There's no issue at all, so I don't know what you're saying. I'm seeing people here. Can you just say hi and where you're saying hi from? Please don't just keep mute. Don't just be mute here. Say something, please. Say something, anything. Let me know who I'm chatting with. Let me know who's online. Anyway, so like I said earlier, the Nigerian Suicide Prevention Initiative hotline is +234. If you're calling out of Nigeria, +234 806 1210 6493. I'm sure every country has their own hotline, suicide prevention initiative hotlines. So you just need to find out what the number is wherever you are, and note that number. God forbid you need it. God forbid somebody needs it. The number is there, you know, so you can call the number and talk to someone. So don't be silent about it. It's not a big deal. If you're feeling anyhow, somehow, you know, you're feeling broken, call the number. After praying about it, call the number, talk to someone. You definitely will be assisted. Okay? Okay, so oh, Happy, you've not answered me. What do you mean by the issue of Nigerian people in Dubai? Can you please answer that ASAP before I zap? Can you please answer, like rephrase your question? Because I honestly don't know what you mean by the issue of Nigerian people in Dubai. What happened to Nigerians in Dubai? Okay, who is here? Berry Cherry. Hello, girl. How you doing? Princess goes, Toying B, you look so stunning. Oh, thank you, Princess. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Prince, you're the one I'm waiting. I mean, Happy Destiny. You're the one I'm waiting for.
Hello, girl. How you doing?
You're the one I'm waiting for.
Princess goes, Toying B, you look so stunning.
Sorry. Once I get your question, I will answer it, then sign out. Happy Destiny goes, we want to come sometime. We want to come some time ago, and someone said Nigeria have issues in gold shop. Happy Destiny, that is not true. It's so not true. Never happened. If you watch my, let me see the episode of the video, so that I'll give you the right information. Just a minute. What episode was it again? Okay, go to my YouTube channel, Oluwatoyin Balogo. Wait, let me check it out myself now. Give it to you. Okay, I'm going to give you the information. That story is not true, my ear. It is so not true. All right, Happy Destiny. If you go to my YouTube channel, Oluwatoyin Balogun, go to this episode. It's coming up now. I'm going to give you the episode 2. My second episode, right? Episode 2, TBW, an important message for Nigerians in Dubai and out of Dubai. Episode 2 of TBW, Oluwatoyin Balogun. You will see what you would, if you listen, you will hear the message, right? So I wouldn't want to go into it. The information was not, the news was not true. Nigerians have, they've been safe and they're safe. They're still safe in Dubai. They're still giving out issues to, I mean, they're still giving out visas to everyone, Nigerians everywhere, you know. That issue of that gold souk thing, I know what you're talking about. Never happened. It's not true. So get the full gist on my YouTube channel, Oluwatoyin Balogun, episode 2, right? When we finish this conversation, please go and watch it. All right, thanks. You're welcome. Happy destiny. Prince Kanye goes, what about the man who killed lady in Lagos? The man who killed lady. Was it the mom? The man who killed his mom? Is it that one you're talking about? Anyway, for all the news, please visit my blog. I'm going to give you my. You cut our hair. Okay, I don't know about that. I've not heard about it, Prince Kennedy. Right, but the news, I have some fresh news on the blog. So, guys, I'm going to round up now. I really. Blackie Iyang, hey, I see you. T big up. Hi, Blackie. Can I have a dance? Rosie, ah. 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 Blackie, are you seeing me? Can I have a dance? Rosie, ah. Can I have a dance? Rosie, can I have a dance? Rosie, ah. This stuff is making me. Big, but I'm not big. Can I have a dance, Rosie? Lord have mercy. Hi, Blackie. Good to have you on board. Thanks for coming on board, Blackie. My friend from Tete. Woo. Anyway, so guys, I'm going to leave you in a couple of minutes. But before I do, let me tell you how and where I can be reached, right? Blackie, nice to have you. Prince Kennedy, thanks for coming. Happy Destiny, thanks for coming and the compliments. Okay, so I can be reached on Facebook, www.facebook.com/Toyinb, Toyenb. On Twitter at Toyinb, Toyenb. Instagram at Toyinb's World, Toyenbsworld. LinkedIn, Google Plus, and YouTube, Oluwa Toyin Balogun. OluwaToyinBalogun. Okay? Love the Rosie Skank. Of course, Blackie, I love it. I did and I still do. Nice, lucky. This is the first time you're watching me or leaving a comment. Anyway, you're welcome. Thanks for coming. Abdullahi Ali goes, hi. Hi, Abdullahi. Prince Kennedy goes, you're welcome. You're welcome. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Merci beaucoup. So check out the blog for more news, breaking, trending, global. We don't do more of gossip. We do more of events and entertainment. And we interview all the Hollywood and Nollywood celebrities that come from anywhere, everywhere, here in Dubai. I am the, I wouldn't say, I'm not, I don't want to sound like I'm boasting. I'm about the only Nigerian blogger who actually keeps tab on every superstar that comes to Dubai. Especially those Nigerian artists. I've done P-Square, I've done Banky W, I've done Sheyi Shei, I've done Obafemi Martin, I've done Files a Bad Guy. So many. So, in order not to sound like I'm just blah, 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 just check out everything on my blog, Toyinb's World, www.toyinbalogun.com. Toyinb's World, toyinbalogun.com. Rejoice Oma Dudu says hello. Hi, Rejoice. Let's rejoice and be happy and be merry. We're rejoicing. Thanks for coming on board, Rejoice. Who else is here? Ali goes, hi. Hi, Ali. Okay, so. I wish I could play that Blackie song to round up. But if I put this, my video on YouTube, it would be like copyrights, blah, blah, blah. So that's why I don't put music. I don't play music. I just sing. I'd have loved to put that Blackie's gang. What? Can I have a dance, Rosie? Oh, can I have a dance, Rosie? Oh, Lord have mercy. I will dance round the hall. I will dance round the hall. Oh my God. I will dance. So who's here? Who's still here? Who's saying hi? Who wants to say hi? I'm signing out in a bit. Let me go and rest my throat. Right? Yeah, so if you're a makeup artist and you want a hookup, leave your details on this thread now or as soon as you watch the video so that I can get in touch with you as soon as possible. All right, so I'd like to thank everybody for coming on board. And I can also be reached on via email at toyinb@gmail.com. Two is 12 yin, yeenb at gmail.com. And I can be reached on the telephone. The number is +971 557 581045. I repeat the number again. +971 557 581045. All right, so we always do, well, not always, most times I do my chat on Tuesday evening. So hopefully we'll see you again next Tuesday, God willing. But if anything crops up before then, I would let you know on my Facebook page, ToyinB at ToyinB. So if you have not liked the page, do like the page now and put the notification on. So that as soon as I come on live, you will be notified and you know that I'm live and you can join us in our chats. So like my page, www.facebook.com/toyinb, ToyinB. So till I see you guys again next week, Tuesday, on or before Tuesday, it's me, your Doro blogger, Oluwa Toyin Noimat Balogo, signing out with so much love, hugs and kisses. Prince Kennedy goes, God bless you. Amen. God bless. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone, for coming on board. God bless you and yours. God bless me and mine. God bless every one of us. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time. I love you guys. See you on Tuesday. Cheers. Bye. Cheers. Bye-bye.